Hi, I'm Matt Knapp, and here are the three things you need to know this week. Number one, the holidays. Like clockwork, the moment Halloween is over, the winter holidays start invading our thoughts, our schedules, and our bank accounts.
10 a.m., Santa's coming to town.
Santa!
And before things get a little too crazy, we want to tell you about two events happening in a few weeks. The first is Lights of Remembrance. Lights of Remembrance is a service to remember who and what you've lost in your life. Loss is hard. So if you're facing this upcoming holiday season without familiar faces and opportunities, please join us for a special service on November 21st at 5 p.m. at Harbor Cove Central Campus. Find comfort in God's presence as we remember the difficult losses in order to move forward with hope. The second event is the very next week on November 28th called Jingle Jam. Jingle Jam, a Christmas party and service project big enough for the whole family, will be on November 28th at 5 p.m. at Central Campus. Before all the baking and the shopping and the endless rolls of wrapping paper, join us for an unforgettable Christmas experience complete with fun, games, music, and lights. We'll also be putting together gift bags of Christmas cheer and appreciation for the middle school teachers in our community. We need your help with that too. On Sundays, starting today, you can pick up a shopping list of all the items that we need, or you can just donate some money and we'll do all the shopping for you. Okay, that's enough Christmas for right now. Number two, Rooted Recap. Here's Jeremy with another recap of last week's Rooted topic.
There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, we need to talk.
That's not how that goes.
Money is simply a valuable resource. Everybody needs to know what to do with it. And thankfully, Jesus taught about money quite a lot.
Thank goodness.
The first thing we learn from Jesus about money is that it's not designed to store up more wealth or buy worldly pleasures. It's designed to be used for heavenly purposes, God's purposes. So ultimately, it's about what's in our hearts.
I see you've had a change of heart.
We also learn that in the end, money doesn't really belong to us. It all belongs to God, and it's to be used for His purposes. So if we're supposed to use money for God's purposes and not our own, then what does God think of money? What should we do with it? Well, it's as simple as 1, 2, 3. Give, save, and spend. In the end, give, save, and spend could also be talked about as trust, wisdom, and priorities. We give because we trust God that we'll have enough. We save because we want to be wise with God's stuff that He's given us. And we spend, well, with God's priorities in mind.
You better get your priorities straight.
We know God wants us to be generous with money, but we also know that He wants us to be generous with the good news of Jesus. He wants us to tell others about it. So, how can we do that well? That's our topic this week. Enjoy the journey.
Thanks, Jeremy. Be sure to check out YouTube and our app for longer versions of the weekly recaps. Number three, fun fact. In order to fall asleep, you have to pretend to be asleep. And those are the three things you need to know this week. If you have any questions, contact the church office.